Hi there, I'm Bonnie Jean, and if you have been around the Carp Farmers Market, the Ottawa Farmers Market, or the Main Street Farmers Market, as well as some of the different craft shows and foodie markets around Ottawa, you might know me as the Tea Lady. I've been bringing my specialty herbal tea blends to the Ottawa area for well over a decade now, and today for the holiday season, I wanted to talk to you about two of my favorite blends to do up during the holidays. I have a rooibos chai, which works really, really well during this season because it's so warming and spicy, and candy cane tea, which I only make for the Christmas sales. We're going to start by getting the chai tea steeping. And I'm going to use my special holiday pot. This is the chai. You can see it. It's very beautiful to look at and smell. I wish you could smell it. That cardamom and pink peppercorns make it so Christmassy looking. Very good Christmas gift. Stocking stuffer. 2 heaping tablespoons. Let's be generous. It's okay to use hot water with rooibos tea. I know sometimes you are a little nervous about the temperature of your water. With green tea, you have to be very careful. With some herbal teas, it's better not for it to be boiling, but with rooibos and with all those seeds and spices, they're not so delicate and they're not so sensitive to very hot water. And so we'll steep that. The 2 tablespoons teapot like this holds about 4 cups. We'll let that steep for a little while. And the second tea that I want to share with you this evening is the candy cane tea. And another method of making the candy cane tea is steeping it in a little device that I love. I use this device every day, actually, for my morning green tea blend. And this is a Bodum-style coffee press. I just got it from IKEA. This is a single-serving one, and I also have a larger one. But we'll do the candy cane tea, which is over here in my Christmas basket, which you'll see on my table at the farmer's market this weekend, Sunday, December 10th at the Aberdeen Pavilion. For this particular one, I'm only going to use 1 tablespoon because this pot holds a large mug or 2 cups of water. Quite a bit in these bags of candy cane tea. Can't seem to get a heaping tablespoon out of these little bags, so I'm going to just do it in 2 goes. The candy cane tea is a real hit. People love it, and they always ask me when the season starts coming on during November, when is the candy cane tea ready? When is the candy cane tea ready? It's basically peppermint, ground vanilla, and lots of stevia leaves to make it sweet so that it does taste like a candy. It's surprising how much like a candy cane it does taste. And the other good thing about this is that, during the season we tend to overindulge a little bit during dinner. And the peppermint is very helpful for digestive distress. It's helpful to let you settle your stomach, and if you feel uncomfortable because there's certain things you maybe shouldn't have eaten, or maybe you just ate too much, it's a good one to have after dinner. The other thing is too, we've been using the candy cane tea around here because I have a couple of children around that have been coughing since they started school in September, and so the peppermint helps alleviate that. Peppermint's very good for breathing and for coughing. It's very aromatic. Even just smelling it, it's just wonderful. The peppermint tea doesn't take that long to steep. Certainly you don't need to sweeten it. In the meantime, I want to tell you what makes my chai special. But first of all, I'm going to tell you how my daughter makes the chai. She steeps it in milk on the stove in a pot in the evening, and then she does it before bed, and then she turns the stove off and puts a lid on, goes to bed, leaves it there all night, wakes up in the morning, adds a bit of honey, and in the summertime mostly she does this. She pours it through a strainer into a blender full of ice and makes a frozen chai latte. this is really exciting for her. And actually steeping the chai in milk is the traditional way to do Indian chai. But I prefer a different way of doing it because I'm not much of a milk drinker. So I wanted to tell you that chai is actually the word for tea. But in North America, we've come to understand chai as being a certain Indian spice tea. So when I did my chai, I wanted it to be unique. And the one flavor, I have a very special flavor in my chai that I haven't seen in anyone else's chai. And that is mace. This is whole mace. I wish you could smell it. It's fabulous. And or aromatic. And I crush that up and I put that in my chai blend. Mace, you might be familiar with from your grandmother's pumpkin pie recipes or the pumpkin spice recipe the pumpkin spice flavoring that comes in the fall that everybody goes crazy about. That mace is one of the key flavors of that one. So that's what makes my chai special. Let's see, this is probably ready. So we just push that down, and the nice thing I like about this is that when you're done, you just put the grounds in the composter and just give it a rinse. So I'm gonna take a sip of this because I think that having fresh breath is going to help me make this video. Oh yeah, very sweet, very minty, just like a candy cane. Great stocking stuffer. Now, for the chai, there's something that I do to make it extra, extra, extra special for the holiday season. And I only do this in December. And that is, before I serve it, I add to the cup a spoonful of butter. And a splash of spiced rum. How's that for a festive tea? Some people call it a hot toddy. Whatever it is, it's very relaxing. It's very special and very flavorful. You don't have to use spiced rum. You can use regular rum, or if you don't want alcohol, you could also choose to go into your baking cupboard. And there is a thing called rum extract that's used in baking to make that rum flavoring. So you add the hot tea over the butter. This looks like it's been steeped enough. Generally I would steep it longer because I like it really, really spicy, but 5 minutes will do the trick. The longer you steep it, the stronger it'll get. Get that butter all melted. And what ends up happening is that it is really rich and smooth. And of course, it has a bit of a kick. Perfect. The butter has just a touch of salt. Very, very nice. So I hope I've given you some ideas for things that you can serve before, during, and after dinner during the season, or for something you can have special for yourself. And I hope to see you in the new year at the Carp Farmers Market, or sooner, Sunday, at Aberdeen Pavilion. And I wish everybody a happy, peaceful, and joyful holiday season.